Now, student of class 11th, we are here again with a new video, and the chapter is motion in plane, means motion in two dimension. In the previous video, we had understand about the motion in a straight line and motion in one dimension. Now it is motion in two dimension, or we can say motion in plane. So let us start the video and understand the topic in this chapter, motion in plane. Now the topic we are going to cover, motion in plane, is vector addition, velocity, acceleration and projectile motion. Now what is scalar and vector, we had discussed in the previous chapters. Now again, what the mathematical operation of vector means, addition, subtraction and multiplication, we will learn in this video. Now graphical addition and subtraction of vector. A vector is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. Position is an example of vector quantity. Means if you have to describe the position, you have to describe the magnitude as well as direction. A scalar is a quantity whose with no direction, and the mass of an object is an example of a scalar quantity. Means those quantity which do not require direction to represent, they are a scalar quantity. Means only magnitude is required. So mass is an example of a scalar quantity, and position is an example of vector quantity. So many vector and scalar quantity we discussed in the previous chapter. You make the list of the vector quantity and scalar quantity and revise and understand what are the scalar and vector. Now how can we write the vector? What are the notation? In the book, many books, the vector is represented by a bold letter, or arrow is also on the letters. If you are seeing here, F is written bold. This is also the representation of vector quantity. Or you can write F and put an arrow on that. This is also the representation of vector quantity. Now, if you have to write the magnitude of vector, अगर हमें magnitude लिखना है vector का, value लिखना है, तो simply we can write, see F is written not in bold letter, it is simply F, or we can write in a vector form and use mod. If the vector quantity is written in the mod, it means it is a scalar quantity. Means F vector in the mod is the magnitude of the given quantity. The direction of vector might be 35 degrees south of east, 20 degree above the x-axis, or like this we can introduce the direction with the any of the value to represent vector quantity. Now a scalar, suppose the mass is a scalar quantity, symbol is m, so it is not boldface and no arrow. So a scalar is written simply like m is written over here, and vector, if you see your book NCERT, the bold letters are the vector representation. If you have write in your copy, you are not going to write every time bold letter, so you can write letter and put arrow on that, so it is distinguished that you are writing the vector quantity. So this is the way how to represent the vector quantity while writing. Now how can you add any given vector? Suppose you had add two vector f1 and f2. Now if you see vector f1, the starting point, tail and head, it is directed to any direction. The second vector is f2, it is also one arrowhead and a tail. So what is the rule to add two vector quantity by graphical representation? To add vector graphically, they must be placed tip to tail, means the tail of the second can be put on the tip of the first. If you see, the tail of f2 is put in on the head of f1, so the resultant will be f1 plus f2, and tail to head, the you see the red color line R, which is the resultant, it is joined from tail of f1 to head of f2. This is the way to add any of the two given vector quantity. So this is the resultant. रिजल्टेंट मीन्स इन दोनों का जो वैल्यू है वेक्टर फॉर्म में वो आर है, मीन्स ये रिजल्टेंट है उनका. दिस इज द वे टू एड एनी वेक्टर क्वांटिटी विद हेल्प ऑफ ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. नाउ हाउ मेनी टाइप ऑफ वेक्टर आर देयर? सी, दिस इज द फर्स्ट, दिस इज कॉल्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट वेक्टर. देयर इज अ टेल एंड हेड. पॉइंट ए इज टेल एंड बी इज हेड. If you see parallel vector, two vectors in the same direction, they are known as parallel vector C. And if you see the figure number D, two vectors are opposite in direction, they are called anti-parallel. And if you see the B, point A to point B, it is a displacement vector, and from A to B the path 1, A to B the path 2, A to B the path 3, but the position vector is, the displacement vector is only the straight line. So this is the way to represent the type of vector. Now relative displacement of vector. Suppose we had drawn a coordinate x, y and z. Suppose point P1 has any value of the coordinate in x axis and y axis. P1 and the point P2, after some time the point P2 shifted to point P3. So the addition of this, yani ki kya value hogi, iske hum isko add karte hain. So if the P2, or we can say the vector B, is add tip to tail, means hamare vector A ke head par vector B ka tail hai, aur vector A ke tail se vector B ke head ko join kar dein, to we are getting the value C, and C is the resultant. So what is C? C is equal to A plus B. Or we can say, if you have to subtract, to C minus A is equal to B. This is a addition and subtraction of the vector. Next is vector addition via parallelogram. Suppose there are two vector A and B. They are originating from a point. You see the vector A and vector B. If you draw a line parallel to vector B with a dotted line, and if you draw a vector A with a dotted line parallel to vector A given, then the diagonal will, the value of the resultant, means C is the resultant of the two given vector in the form of parallelogram. So vector A and vector B, if they have same origin, ek hi point se dono vector arise ho rahe hain, to hum isko law of parallelogram se add karenge. Kya karna hoga isme, humko vector B ke parallel ek vector banana hoga, vector A ke parallel ek vector banana hoga, aur uske baad jo bana hua parallelogram hai, iske dono diagonal ko milayenge, to jo diagonal ki value hogi bhai hamare vector A aur B ka resultant hoga, means A plus B is equal to B plus A, or we can say C. This is the way how to add vector via parallelogram. Now if you see in this figure, vector A is at 60 degree from the x axis. Now it is shifted to 140 degree, and the vector B is there. So on the arrowhead of the A, the tail of the B is kept, and from tail of the A, the arrow of the B is joined, and it is the C, means resultant of the vector A and B is C. So what is the direction of C? We can see the direction of C is theta degree from the origin, means from where the vector A started. So this you can add in this way. Now graphical subtraction of vector. Suppose we had to subtract vector A and B. So A minus B ka matlab hoga A plus minus B, means we have to reverse the direction of B. Agar humko B ka direction south se north ki taraf diya hua hai, to agar hum usko north se south ki taraf ghuma dein, to hamara wo minus B ho jayega. Means agar hum A aur B ko add kar dein with B minus sign, to wo hamara jo value aayega wo A minus B hoga, means subtraction. Where vector minus B has some magnitude, but B as B, but points in the opposite direction. The value of B remains same, but direction will be opposite. Vector may be moved any way you please to place them tip to tail, provided that you do not change their length nor the rotate them. Now what are the component of given vector? Suppose that this is a vector A at angle theta from the x axis. So to make the component of vector A, if you draw a perpendicular from the tip of the A to x axis and to y axis, so you will get the value ax and ay. So what is ax? If you use trigonometry, so ax is equal to a cos theta and ay is equal to a sin theta. Now two component of vector A is a cos theta and a sin theta. The horizontal component is a cos theta and vertical component is a sin theta. If you add both these vector, you will get the resultant a. So this is called vector components. Now if you see in this diagram, the vector component, vector a, the vector a is resolved into two, ay and ax. Vector b is resolved into two, by and bx. Bx is a horizontal, by is a vertical, and vector c is resolved into two, cy is vertical and cx is horizontal. So this is the way how to resolve the vector into components. Now graphical method for addition. This we had discussed earlier. Now what is unit vector? The vector divided by its magnitude is called unit vector. Suppose vector a upon a means, if the vector is divided by its magnitude, we will get the unit vector means 1. Unit means 1. So unit vector in the rectangular coordinate I cap, I ke upar ek aise bana hua hai, usko hum cap padhte hain, that is called I cap, j cap and k cap. I cap is directed in the x axis, j cap is directed to y axis, and k cap is directed towards the z axis. And the value of I, j and k is 1. Means that if I say I cap, it means I am telling about the direction in x axis and the value is 1. If I say j cap, so j cap means in the y axis value is 1. If I say k cap, means value is 1 towards the z. So these are called unit vector in rectangular coordinates. I cap, j cap and k cap. Now how can you make the component in the rectangular coordinate? Suppose that there is a vector a. Vector a can be resolved in x axis. So we can say ax, ax is the magnitude and I cap is the direction, value is 1. So ax I cap, ax I cap means the direction of a is in x axis, and ay j cap, the component of a in the y axis is ay and the direction is j cap, means ay j cap, and in z axis it is az k cap. So these are the coordinate in x, y and z, means the vector component in rectangular coordinate. So we can write vector a as ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap, and vector b as bx I cap, by j cap and bz k cap. These are the rectangular component of vector a and vector b. Now this is all about the how to write the vector. This is just a intro to you all. You take your NCRT, revise from your NCRT reference also you can use, solve the question, try to understand how to write the vector in the different way, what are the component of the vector, what are the type of the vector. In this video we learn this. If you have any problem, you can call me on my number